Canadian delegation joining MPs in the West Bank. Mahmoud Kassim is the CEO of International Development and Relief Foundation Canada. That's IDRF. It's a humanitarian aid organization, and they've been providing assistance in the West Bank for 30 years. We reached him in Jerusalem, where it is very late right now. So, Mahmoud, thank you so much for staying up so we could have this chat.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
So you've been visiting the Palestinian communities in the Middle East with Canadian MPs. First, help us understand, what's the main goal of this visit to the West Bank?
So this is the objective is to bring a delegation that's come with us, that's been organized by the TCMV, the Canadian Muslim Vote. And the entire purpose is for our MPs from the Liberal Party as well as the NDP Party to see the situation on the ground, the humanitarian crisis that's taking place, not only in Gaza, but also here in the West Bank, and for them to use their voices and to advocate and to also be witnesses to what is taking place here in West Bank.
You have five MPs with you, three of them NDP, two of them Liberal. Let me ask you, what kind of impact do you think this visit's going to have?
It's definitely been an eye-opening trip for all of them and for the rest of us that are as part of this delegation. And I truly believe upon their return, they'll be able to advocate. They will be able to share the message, share the stories of bringing peace and hopefully some sort of calm to the difficulties that they are facing here through their voices in Parliament.
How has the presence of Canadian MPs in the West Bank been received by the local communities? And what do Palestinian people, what are they having to say about it, the fact that they're seeing these representatives?
Yeah, it's been a great engagement for them. There's been a lot of conversations that they've had directly with the people here in Palestine. They've had the chance to listen to them, to hear their stories firsthand. Understand some of the challenges and difficulties that they face. They also share messages with the MPs that they understand that the people of Canada are a voice of support for them. They have even received messages of love and peace from Canadian citizens. And it's reassuring for them to hear these words as well.
And you have also visited refugee camps. What specific challenges are Palestinian refugees facing in the areas that you visited?
Yeah, it's really dire situation. A lot of their infrastructure is damaged. After the attacks on October the 7th, many of the Palestinians, even in the West Bank now, are not able to, go to their jobs. They're not able to have access to some of the needs that they would usually a need or aid would be coming in. They've had a lot of blockades and closures and checkpoints. And it's just been a very difficult process for them to move around and to have access to things for their families. So it was very challenging to see, emotional experience for all of us. And hopefully there will be some, change in the situation soon.
The U.S. and the U.K. have sanctioned individuals, specifically Israeli settlers, implicated in attacks on Palestinians. I wonder, what can countries like Canada do to help bring peace to this part of the world and to the people who are in need?
No, definitely. I mean, Canada can play an important role. Canada has been known in the past to be a nation that has promoted peace. We were part of the UN Charter when that was formed, and it's important that we continue to share this message and be a strong voice for the people, regardless of where they are, if they are facing any challenges or human rights issues, and they have to see these on a daily basis. Canada can be a very strong voice for the marginalized communities.
Mahmoud Kassim is the CEO of IDRF Canada.